A 22.4-liter container has a total pressure of 760 torr at 0 degrees Celsius and contains three different gases, nitrogen, helium, and argon. If the partial pressure of the nitrogen is 250 torr and the partial pressure of argon is 130 torr, how many moles of helium are in the tank? So, what are we looking for? We're looking for moles of helium. What information do we have? Well, we have 22.4 liters, which is a volume, right? We have a total volume. We have a total pressure of 760 torr. So we have a total pressure. And we have a temperature, 0.0 degrees Celsius. So we have a temperature. We also have the partial pressure of the nitrogen. So the partial pressure of the nitrogen is 250 torr. And we have the partial pressure of the argon, which is 130 torr. We want to know moles of helium. So if you'll remember back to our equations within the gas laws, looks like the only one that's going to help us right now is our PV equals nRT. Okay. Avogadro's law isn't going to help us because we don't have more than one volume. So the only other equation that has N in it, or moles, is PV equals nRT. We have several things here, right? We have a volume, we have a total pressure, we have R, which is a constant, we can always look that up, and we have a temperature. So there's more than one way that we can go about this. But it might help to remember that the total pressure in a system is equal to the sum of the partial pressures of each piece. So the total pressure in the system is equal to the pressure of the nitrogen plus the pressure of the helium plus the pressure of the argon. We have the total pressure, it was given to us in the problem, as was the pressure of the nitrogen and the argon. So we can solve for the pressure of the one we don't know, the pressure of the helium. So 760 torr is equal to 250 torr plus the helium, which we don't know, plus the argon, which is 130 torr. So we can solve for the pressure of the helium by subtracting the 250 and subtracting the 130 from both sides. That leaves us with a partial pressure of helium of 380 torr. So now we can use PV equals nRT and solve for the number of moles of helium. Now, why don't we want to use the total pressure in this equation? Well, the reason we didn't stick total pressure in PV equals nRT is that would give us the total number of moles. So we only want the moles of helium. So we are only going to put the pressure of the helium in PV equals nRT. So PV equals nRT, we want to solve for N. So PV divided by RT equals N. The pressure of the helium is 380 torr. Okay. The volume is 22.4 liters. Okay. Which R are we going to use? So remember that there are multiple R's. And as I said in class, you always want to pick the R that corresponds with the pressure units that you're using or the pressure units that you're looking for. Because R is always measured in a volume of liters and a temperature of Kelvin. So, and an amount of moles. So the only thing that changes within an R value is the pressure units. In this case, we have pressures of torr, so we want to pick the R that has torr in it. And that means going with the 62.3. units of liter torr over mole Kelvin. You'll see that the torr will cancel, the liters will cancel, and of course when we put the temperature in here, we're not going to put 0 degrees Celsius. Right? We're going to convert that into Kelvin. Remember that it is Celsius plus 273 to get to Kelvin, so since we're at zero, it's 273 Kelvin. So our Kelvin will cancel, leaving us with a unit of moles, which is appropriate since that's what we're looking for. So 380 times 22.4. And then we're going to divide by 62.3 times 273, making sure we're using parentheses as appropriate. And we should get an answer of 0.500 moles. So again, the biggest mistake I see in these problems is that students forget that when you're using R, you need your stuff to cancel out, which means that temperature is always going to be measured in Kelvin. Volume should always be in liters, right? Since R always has a volume of liters, when you put your volume in here, it needs to be in liters. If you put a volume in milliliters, those will not cancel. If you put a temperature in Celsius, your units will not cancel. Okay, or they pick an R that does not correspond to the pressure that they're given. So again, make sure that your units cancel. Thank you so much for listening.